We're all clapping for all of you, all the time, every one of you. Thank you for being here. Now, you both, you grew up near each other, and Jennifer, we know you're from the Bronx. Leah, you grew up in Brooklyn, so I don't know the difference between, I don't know a sort of Bronx accent or a Brooklyn accent. What is an accent? How do I get to do a proper full Bronx accent?
Well, there's different ones. Like Bronx Italian and Bronx Puerto Rican, and Brooklyn Italian is more like Bronx Italian.
Yeah. And then also...
But the same, not from the Bronx. If you're from the Bronx, doesn't mean you have all of the exact same accent.
Okay, so how do I do your accent? What do I do?
When I was growing up, I talked like this. I was like very, hi, how are you? What do you want? I have my hoops on.
Yeah. I got my hoops on.
I love to wear a lot of eyeliner.
And you have to...
And you were like,
I was like, I'm talking to you, or I'm talking to her. She's a whore.
And we said she's a slut.
Yeah.
She's a slut.
I'm whore. Now you have to say, like, talk.
I'm talk.
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 Talking to her.
I'm talking to her. I feel like I'm drunk. It's making me talk like I've had a couple of drinks.
A little bit. Yes.
It's not bad.
You don't play that in the Bronx.
Yeah.
Okay.
What do we play then? What am I? So I'm talk.
No, you said it right. Is it talk? And you have to
talk.
Yeah. I was talking to her.
Talking to her.
Right. And a lot of hands.
And a lot of hands. Yeah. Yeah.
But Italian hands are different than Puerto Rican hands.
Exactly.
Oh, I see. So Italian hands are here.
Puerto Rican hands. Italian hands are like with the pinky.
With the pinky and the horn, like you give the Italian horn when you you talk a lot.
But Puerto Rican hands are more like this.
Oh, nice.
Like, don't.
Can you do? Can you do good impressions of each other? Can you do a good impression of Leah Remini?
She thinks she does.
Oh, really?
It's so crazy weird. Like her.
Do it again. Go on.
You see what I'm saying?
Go on.
So crazy. What do I do for you?
Like her imitation of me is like, none of my life.
That's exactly how you act.
And then she's like, and your other imitation is that I call everybody. I don't.
Look at it.
I will mess up your bun, Jennifer. I will mess up your bun.
Did you see the absolute seriousness that Jennifer responded when you just mentioned the fact that you might mess up her bun?
She went, I know.
Like, it was all fun and games. It was all fun and games until someone...
I will cut you, bitch. I will cut you, bitch. Yes.
Now, you've been friends for a very, very long time, which I think is clear to all of us. Now, Leah, tell me. So, I imagine being a dear close friend of J-Lo's comes with some sort of... intrusion on your life. What's it like when you're constantly being surrounded by paparazzi and things like that? Is it insane to be in a friendship like that?
You know, it's in the beginning it was, you know, because I was like the protector, you know, I felt like her protector, and we went shopping or something.
I know, yeah.
And I'm like in the car, and there's like all of a sudden 20 paparazzi like pulling U-turns and putting people's lives in danger, you know, so I become her protector. And it's like a one-man show. I'm literally in the car, I'm pulling U-turns, I'm trying to go, and I'm like, for this, for that, and you know, I'm sweating, like I put makeup on because I knew I'd probably be followed, you know, going to get tampons or whatever. And like, you know, it's just a whole other like scene.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Like once in a while they'll see me at Starbucks and they're like, it's douchebag, you know what I mean? But this is a whole other life, right?
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, and then I look over at her, like I'm sweating, my makeup is, you know, and she's just like, you know, scrolling through Instagram or just no care of the world.
Well, because I guess if it's every day, it's every day, right?
Exactly, just,
you get used to it and you know nothing, you hope nothing's going to happen most times.
Sure.
Everything is okay.
Do you think, because celebrity culture has changed a great deal, like in the age of social media and things like that, do you think it's worse now or was it worse when everything was just about tabloids?
You know, it's both. I hated when we didn't have any voice for ourselves. When it was just tabloids, you know, you were just getting all of this, like, kind of negative, kind of crappy information all the time. Now, at least you get to know us a little bit more on social media because we get to speak for ourselves, and I like that interaction. But because there's so many more channels with the internet and there's so many more outlets, it's more paparazzi because they're always looking for content. Everybody's always looking for content. So, you know, in a way, it was worse, and now it's still worse.
You get to say, like, you get to...
No,
but you get to answer and you get to say, and people, you
and
get
I like
to
that
share.
Better, yeah, for sure. Yeah.